guys, Nicole and Albert here again from the Relax My Dog vlog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week we're going to be giving you all of the tips that you need to bathe your dog. We recommend doing this at least once every 3 months. But for some dogs who spend a lot of time outdoors or who have skin conditions, it's important to do this even more frequently. So here's everything that you need to know about bathing and grooming your dog. So we'll start with the bathing routine. Now, many dogs are very scared of getting into the water, so you are going to have to make sure that you remain calm and you're talking to your dog in a really calm voice the whole way through. Now, we have a lot of bath time music on Relax My Dog, so why don't you just put a playlist on, put one of our videos on, and this will help to calm him down as well. It'll bring down both of his blood pressure and his stress levels, and it'll make your job a lot easier. So first of all, you need to give your dog a really good brush to make sure that you've got rid of all of his dead hair. Once you've done this, place him into a bathtub or a sink, depending on how big he is, and this needs to be filled with about 3 to 4 inches of lukewarm water. Then you can use a spray hose or a plastic pitcher or an unbreakable cup and just pour the lukewarm water over it, making sure that all of his fur is nice and wet. Now you need to be really careful when you're doing this and make sure that no water is getting into his eyes or his ears. So then you just need to gently massage in some shampoo. Now you can get doggy shampoo from any good pet store. There's loads of different ranges available, so just ask someone in there which is the best for your dog. You need to gently massage in the shampoo from the head to the tail. Obviously, don't get it in his eyes because that will really not make him very happy. And just keep massaging this gently through his skin. And then just rinse and repeat as needed. Once he's completely rinsed off, make sure that you dry him thoroughly. This is really, really important. Now you can get loads of really, really good pet towels, again, available from any pet shop. Now it's really important to remember that depending on the breed of your dog, if your dog has wrinkles on his face, such as a Shar Pei or a pug, you are going to have to spend more attention on their face. They have their wrinkles and they can get really bad skin infections inside these wrinkles if they're not cleaned properly. So we recommend just wetting cotton wool and just wiping through all of the folds in their face and then make sure this is dried off thoroughly before you leave it. Okay, so now I'm just going to run through a couple more tips about how to groom your dog between bathing times. Number one is brushing your dog. So regular grooming is really important, especially for some breeds who have the longer hair. It helps to keep your dog's coat in good condition. Removing dirt, spreading natural oils throughout their coat, prevents tangles as well in long-haired dogs, and it keeps their skin clean. Plus, grooming time is a really good time to check for any fleas. They're the little black specks that you'll see on your dog's skin. Many dogs develop really thick coats in the winter and they'll shed these in the spring. So if you do notice that your dog's shedding more in the spring, this is completely normal. For indoor dogs, they usually shed at a very even rate, so they'll shed throughout the year because they're not used to being outside. It also depends on the breed. As we know, there's quite a lot of hypoallergenic dogs, such as cockapoos and dogs like that, who won't shed as much. That's why they're perfect for people with allergies. So many dogs can get a variety of different skin conditions, and it's really important to be checking for these. Your dog's skin is an indication of his overall health. So it's really important to keep it clean and healthy. Bathing will do this. So you'll usually know if your dog has developed a skin condition because you'll see him licking, scratching, and maybe chewing at his paws sometimes. If you do notice any of these habits, then we recommend getting yourself over to your vet straight away and they'll be able to prescribe to you whatever it is to get away from this skin condition. When I first got Albert, he had Demodex on his head, so he was thinning on his head. And they just gave us an extra prescription of his flea treatment, and it's gone now. He's got a full head of hair again, haven't you, babe? Okay, so eye care should always be a really important thing for you to check whenever you're grooming your dog. If your dog's eyes show any signs of tearing, cloudiness, or inflammation, it may indicate a health problem. So we recommend facing your dog into a brightly lit area and just having a quick look inside his eyes. So they should be really clear and the area around his pupils should be white. The pupils should be equal in size and there shouldn't be any tearing or discharge or crustiness in the corner of his eyes. Another tip that we've got is if you just roll your thumb very slightly down the bottom of his eyelid, when you look inside, it should be pink. It shouldn't be red, it shouldn't be white, it should be a nice pink, healthy colour. Now, because Albert's a pug cross, pugs are prone to eye problems, so it's really important for me to keep checking Albert's eyes. And if I ever do notice anything, I take him straight to the vets and they just recommend what I need to do for him. So dental care is another really, really important thing to make sure that you're keeping on top of for your dog. So you need to be regularly brushing your dog's teeth. I brush Albert's teeth probably about once every 2 to 3 days, just to make sure that his teeth are nice and healthy and that he's not prone to any gum disease. Now, brushing your teeth is not the only thing. You need to make sure that he's got good chew toys and a healthy diet as well, because this is going to affect the healthiness of his teeth. The last thing you want is any plaque building up on their teeth, because it can actually mean tooth loss. Many, many dogs show signs of gum disease before the age of 4, which is really scary. We should look after their teeth as well as we look after ours. So another really important one, I know the list goes on, but it's ear care. With Albert, I just wet earbuds with lukewarm water and just have a wipe inside of his ear. Now, it's really important to remember cleaning your dog's ears too regularly or too deep inside the ear canal can be really bad for them. So make sure that this is a really gentle, gentle movement. If you probe inside too much, it can cause trauma and infection, which you never want for your pooch. And then we move on to paw care. So I'm going to go through the pads first. Obviously, these are very, very important for your doggy. They provide extra cushioning and these protect their bones. They also provide insulation from extreme weather, and they make sure that if they're walking on rough ground, they're okay. So it's really, really important that you make sure that the pads of their feet don't have any infection, any wounds. This is really, really important. And last but not least, nail care. So as a general rule, your dog's nails need to be clipped if you can hear them clipping on the floor. They shouldn't be touching the floor, they should be ground down before that. Now, different dogs will have different levels of nail care. So for more leisurely dogs, they'll need their nails clipped more frequently. For dogs like Albert, who are walking along pavements, walking through city centres and doing a lot of exercise, his nails don't need clipping that much. When you do clip your dog's nails, make sure that you avoid the quick of the nail. I'm putting a picture up now for you. If you do snag this, it will cause a lot of bleeding and some pain for your pooch, which you don't want. So we hope you enjoyed the video today, and we hope it's taught you a little bit more about bathing and grooming your dog. Now let us know if you do have any more questions or if you have any ideas for next week's video, because we always love hearing your suggestions. We reply to all of our comments here at Relax My Dog, so if you do comment, we'd love to hear from you. But for now, we will see you again next week. Bye! Bye, Abby. Hi guys, Nicole and Albert here again from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. We're recording the video from home this week because Albert wasn't very well this morning, were you? Now, luckily, I knew that Albert was going to be poorly this morning because I know how he communicates his feelings. So that's what this week's video is all about. I'm going to tell you some top tips on how you can tell how your dog is feeling.